Well, guys, you know what? Today I decided to make was a lovely biryani masala. We're going to mix a lovely, exciting biryani masala. Now, biryani, you can either have it spicy, not spicy. And like I was saying, you can take the whole biryani mix. You can buy from Gorima's, Checkers, your any shops, the one-stop shop. Take those spices. You can roast it on the pan. You can take your normal pesto and mortar, or you can take a stamper and you stamp it. If you don't have that, take a brick, for God's sake. And you just stamp the spices, and then you add it in your biryani masala. And whatever spices you got in your cupboard, you can mix it if you can't come visit the auntie. Now, we got all those spices, the whole biryani mix, I'm going to add it in here, right? So your fennel, your aniseed powder, your clove, your cinnamon, all that powder. I've even got ginger and garlic powder. If you want a nice tasty biryani, biryani takes extra masala. So normally in a biryani, it's best to use the fresh ingredients as well, which is your fresh greens, your mint, your coriander, which is your dhania, your fresh thyme, and fresh ginger and garlic. And also what's good for biryani is use your fresh green chilies or your red chilies. You grind that all together, like I said, stamp it, and then you put it into the, marinate the meat or the chicken with either yogurt or mas. Not forgetting, you need to add your saffron as well, if you want to taste the biryani. If you don't have fresh chilies, you can use crushed chilies as well. So you can improvise. So cooking is all about improvisation. If you can't come and visit the auntie, then you must come and then you must mix the spices yourself. You can get the ingredients and you're welcome to mix it. Cooking is all about mixing and how you want it to taste. It's your food. It's your cooking. And the cooking must be from the heart. The love and the energy that goes in the food is very, very important. So to a kilogram of chicken, mutton, or whatever biryani you're making, just use 2 to 3 tablespoons. Marinate your meat or chicken or whatever veg nicely. Use your fresh whole green ingredients like I mentioned, and your saffron, and you marinate it nicely. And then you'll get a delicious biryani. If you can't visit the auntie, you can make it yourself. Maybe next time auntie will cook for you, right?